Hi guys, in this session we'll discuss about earned value analysis as part of project monitoring and control. Earned value analysis. So what is the use of the earned value analysis? So during the schedule, we can inspect the whole project development at any time, whether we are working according to the proposed plan called scheduling. Okay. So and ensuring the various intermediate products quality. So end value analysis is useful to inspect the whole project development at any time in the schedule and inspecting the quality, effort and cost of the whole project development. End value analysis. So what is end value? Is a measure of progress. So progress of what? Progress of various project products or tasks. Various project products, that is the intermediate level project products. Progress is assessed and reported. Okay. So that we discussed in previous sessions. So please go through the previous sessions. Is a measure of progress. And it enables to assess the percent of completeness. So it enables whom? The project managers and the various people who involved in the development. The various people who involved in the development, managers and developers, the percent of completeness of a project using quantitative analysis rather than rely on a gut feeling. So what do you mean quantitative analysis? So determining in terms of quality and process performance objectives. So these are defined in the initial step project scope and defining the objectives. The quality and the various performance issues of the project is defined in the step one. Okay. So that is achieved or not. So during the development, we can inspect at any time from day one to day n and ensuring whether the defined quality is achieving or not of all the project products, the quality of all the project products and the performance of all the project products. So end value analysis is useful to assess. Okay. So it enables managers and developers assess all the project products in terms of quantitative analysis and provides accurate and reliable readings. Reliable readings of performance from as early as 15% into the project. So what do you mean reliability? Okay. It focuses on reliability. So what do you mean reliability? The probability of failure-free operation of particular task. The probability of failure-free operation of particular task or the whole project task. So once the project is started, if you complete the 15% work, so we have to start the investigations or inspections on the whole schedule. What is proposed, okay. What is implementing, that is nothing but the ongoing project, and are we achieving the defined requirements or not that are in proposed plan in terms of software requirement specification. Okay. End value analysis is useful to ensure all the project products or tasks are giving the quantitative results and reliability. So we focus more majorly on reliability. Okay. Then the various terms used in end value analysis in order to assess the project product tasks. Okay. So we'll use these are the various terminologies. BCWS, budgeted cost of work scheduled. Budgeted cost of work scheduled. So prior to development, we'll estimate the cost of the whole project. The whole project in terms of the schedule, in terms of the whole project production, the project is divided into furtherly modules, modules into submodules and so on. So here we are not solving the problem as a single entity, dividing the problem into modules, modules into submodules and so on, various lower level elements. So for this, we'll prepare a schedule, okay, for all the tasks identified in the development from day one to day n. So here we are allotting the budget for every task. Okay. So that we are estimating budgeted cost of all the tasks. Okay. For the, in the given schedule, then BAC, budget at completion. Okay. So here we are estimating the whole budget after completion of the project and before completion of the project. That is before commitment will estimate budget at completion. Okay, budget at completion before commitment to the solution. So that is the whole project tasks estimation. Then BCWP, budgeted cost of work performed. So here work scheduled, that is prior to development. So budgeted cost of work performed during the development. During the development, we can investigate at any time from day one to day end how many tasks are scheduled in week one, week two, and so on, or month one, month two, and so on. Okay, how many are achieved and what is the budget is allotted for these project products, intermediate project products, that is for completed work products. Then ACWP. So ACWP is actual cost of work performed. So here before commitment will allot the budget. This is during development, what is proposed budget, and during development, what is the implementing budget. Okay, so that we are BCWP and ACWP. So it gives quite confusion, these terms. Clearly observe, BCWP gives the information about the various tasks that are scheduled at the time of starting. ACWP gives the actual cost of all the tasks during development. Okay, then scheduled performance index. So this is useful to assess the schedule of the whole task progress. So what is the start time of the particular task and end time of the particular task, whether it is finished by the given deadlines or not for every. So here we are estimating the cost of scheduled performance. All the tasks and their performances cost is estimated. And then schedule variance. So due to the existence of dependency among activities, or sometimes the existence of or presence of critical activities due to changes. Okay, so the schedule is violated. In order to put on track, okay, so what is the difference between the scheduled one and implementing one? Okay, so what is the maximum variation that we are finding here? And then cost performance index, cost of all the delayed tasks. Okay, all the delayed tasks, at the same time all the normal project products. Okay, we'll estimate both. And cost variance, CV. So here, what is the proposed budget? What is the implementing budget? Okay, so what is the difference between these two? That we are calculating in terms of all these parameters: BCWS, BAC, BCWP, ACWP, SPI, SV, CPI, CV. Okay, so this BCWS is calculated for every individual task from top to bottom. The same time bottom to top. Okay, budget at completion is calculated at project end. Budgeted cost of work performed for every task, at every task. Actual cost of work performed, this is also for every task. Scheduled performance index for whole, and schedule variance also for whole the schedule. And cost performance index and cost variance for our individual tasks. Okay, so like this way we'll estimate the various parameters are involved in end value analysis for all the tasks and the final task, the final solution. Okay, now we'll see how to estimate all these parameters. Computing end values, one. Budgeted cost of work scheduled. It determines for each work task represented in the schedule. Okay, BCWS is calculated for every task that is scheduled in the project development from day one to day end for individual project tasks and sub tasks. For every task, we are calculating BCWS. Okay, so here BCWS I. So here I value varies from 1 to n. BCWS I is the effort planned for work task I. Okay, so the effort is nothing but start time of the task and end time of the task. By any chance, if the task is delayed, what is the maximum waiting period? So by this time, it has to start lately and it has to finish by this time. Okay. So BCWS I for all the activities to determine progress at a given point. So progress at a given point is nothing but during the development at any point, we can check the progress of the all the tasks. Progress at a given point along the project schedule. The value of BCWS is the sum of the BCWS I values. Okay. Sum of the BCWS I values. So here we are calculating for individual tasks. Okay. So if you take this is a task BCWS I. So what it is a submodule of module 1. Okay. So when you will achieve this, you need to calculate it. This is the BCWS 1, BCWS 2, BCWS N. Okay. You need to calculate for all this. Then BCWS of module. Okay. So for all levels, we have to calculate this BCWS. Okay. So that is for all tasks that should have been completed by that time in the point in time on the project schedule. Okay. In the given project schedule, we have to calculate BCWS for all the project tasks. Okay. All the parent project tasks, all the grandparent project tasks until finding the solution for the top level element BCWS. Then budget at completion. So using BCWS. So what BCWS is giving budgeted cost of work schedule for individual tasks. Now we are trying to find it for the whole. That is at project end, BAC, budget at completion. So prior to development, we will estimate the BCWS values for all work tasks are summed to derive budget at completion, BAC. So BAC is the summation of all the BCWS of individual tasks. Okay. So it varies from I equal to 1 to N. Okay. So here we will assess the progress of the whole project and intermediate projects and so on. BCWS is defined for the lower level elements. So in order to achieve the higher level elements, you need to integrate all the lower level elements, then you will get parent level information. If you add all the parent level information, you will get grandparent level. Okay. So that is like this way, we will calculate BCWS and BAC values. Okay. For every task. So these are integrated with the others and so on until finding the top level element. Okay. So when you will get this, by integrating all the lower level elements. So here we will calculate BCWS for these modules, module level. Okay. How will you achieve this? By integrating all the next level elements. Okay. Like this way, we'll calculate budget at completion from bottom to top. In the previous case, top to bottom. BCWS from top to bottom. In BAC case, bottom to top. Next, computing end value 2. So the other parameters, budgeted cost of work performed. The previous are scheduled. Now during development, the value of BCWP is computed using BCWS. Okay. So BCWP also calculated from BCWS. Okay. So the previous BCWS is scheduled. BCWP is during development. The sum of the BCWS values of all work tasks that have actually been completed by point in time. So what even point in time at the time of review, how many tasks are finished? For that finished task, we'll calculate BCWP. For the finished tasks only, okay, not all the tasks. For the completed task or completed project products only, we'll calculate BCWP on the project schedule. BCWS represents the budget of the activities that were planned to be completed. So that is scheduled. BCWP represents the budget of the activities that actually were completed. Now, what is the difference between BCWS, BCWP and BAC? BCWS and BAC are scheduled. Okay. At the time of starting the project, the cost of each task is scheduled or defined. Okay. At the same time, BAC. The whole budget to complete the whole project for all the tasks, that is BAC, before commitment to the project development. BCWP during development. That is the difference only. Okay, next, sir. Using the BCWS, BS and BCWP, the other important progress indicators can be computed. Schedule performance index, schedule performance. So what do you mean? Whether we are using the defined schedule or not, and we are achieving the solutions as per the schedule or not, SPI. So SPI is calculated using BCWP divided by BCWS. Okay. So what do you mean BCWP? The project tasks that are completed and scheduled. Okay. Will give performance index of completed tasks. Then schedule variance. So due to the existence of any problem like critical activities, what is the schedule difference? That is proposed and actual implementation. SP is calculated using the two parameters BCWP. Okay, budgeted cost of work performed minus budgeted cost of work scheduled. Schedule variance is calculated. So this SPI, so schedule performance index, is an indication of the efficiency with which the project is utilizing scheduled resources. Okay, so prior to development, the various resources are scheduled. Okay, whether we are effectively using those resources or not. Okay, this SPI will ensure about the efficiency of all the resources are utilized effectively or not. Then person scheduled for completion. Person scheduled for completion. Okay, is calculated BCWS divided by BAC. So this is for scheduled. Okay, how much percentage is completed? At the time of review, how much percentage is completed? Provides an indication of the percentage of the work that have been completed by time T. So what do you mean time T? The review time. So this review may be conducted during development at any time. Of course, these are defined prior to development. Okay, and person complete. So this is schedule. This is the how much work is completed. Okay, is calculated BCWP divided by BAC. Okay, budget cost of work performed divided by budget at completion. So how many tasks are completed divided by the cost of how many tasks are completed divided by the whole budget scheduled. Provides a quantitative indication of the percent of completeness of the project at a given point in time by the given review time. So as we know that FTRs are defined in project schedule. What do you mean FTR? Formal technical reviews by review time. Okay, how much percentage is completed? So that is calculated using these two parameters. How many are completed? Okay, divided by what is the scheduled budget. Next, actual cost of work performed, ACWP, actual cost of work performed. It gives a little bit confusion, we'll see. Actual cost of work performed, ACWP, is the sum of the effort actually expended on work tasks that have been completed by a point in time on the project schedule. Okay, expended work. Okay, actual cost of work performed. So this is generally calculated after knowing the schedule variance only. Okay, schedule variance, because according to the proposed plan only we will work. If any schedule violation is there, so what is the extra amount that we have spent is calculated actual cost of work performed. Okay, so when schedule variance and the other schedule performance index is available, then we can easily calculate this. And also we have to know the budget, how much budget is allotted on this or further. Okay, so it is then possible to compute cost performance index. So it is used, ACWP is used, cost performance index. Okay, so the cost performance index of what? The delayed task. Okay, and of course the delayed task shows impact on the whole development. Okay, so here we are calculating CPI for the delayed task, also the delayed project period. So CPI equal to BCWP divided by ACWP. Okay, how many are finished? Okay, what is the budget allotted for that? Okay, and what is the variation? This is the budget defined at the time of starting. This is the budget spent during development. Okay, So using these two, we can calculate CPI, cost performance index, and then cost variance. So what is the proposed? What is the actual implementation? The difference between BCWP and ACWP will give cost variance. So like this way, we have to calculate all the parameters of end value analysis. Okay, we'll see one simple problem. So try to understand this problem. Assume you are a software project manager, and that you have been asked to compute end value statistics for a small software project. The project has 56 planned work tasks. How many work tasks? 56 planned work tasks that are estimated to require 582 person days to complete. So to finish 56 planned work tasks, 582 human resources are, okay, so person days to complete. So that we calculated effort in critical path analysis and critical path method using various approaches. Of course, lines of code, function point, and COCOMO models. So please go through that. At the time that you have been asked to do the end value analysis, at the time of review, 12 tasks have been completed. Among the 56 planned work tasks, 12 tasks are completed at the time of review. However, the project schedule indicates that 15 tasks should have been completed. At the review time, actually we have planned 15 tasks has to finish. Okay, 15 tasks has to finish by the review time, but 12 tasks only finished. So how many tasks are delayed? 3 tasks are delayed due to some problem. Okay, so those statistics are given. Okay, the following scheduling data in percentage are available from task 1 to task 15. By the given review date, we have to finish 15 tasks. Due to some problem, only 12 tasks are finished. Okay, so how to calculate end value statistics? So this is the tasks from 1 to 15 and the planned effort, actual effort. Okay, so we'll try to find the various parameters of end value analysis. Okay, so what is the problem is given? By the given review time, 12 tasks have been completed rather than 15 tasks. Actually scheduled 15 tasks, but 12 tasks only completed. Okay, so task 1, planned effort is 12. So it may be 12 hours or 12 weeks or 12 months. Assume the case. Okay, assume the case 12 hours. Planned effort is 12 hours. Okay, actual effort 12.5. Okay, what is planned? 12. What is implemented? 12.5. 2, 15. Actually 11. So 3, 13. Planned. Actually 4 more resources are used. Okay, 4, 8. 9 point. So like this way, okay, for 15 tasks are scheduled. Okay, now we have to calculate BCWS, BCWP, BAC, and ACWP, SPI, SV, CPI, CV. Okay, BCWS, what do you mean BCWS? Budgeted cost of work scheduled. Okay, so what is the work scheduled? Okay, so we'll see one by one. BCWS. So how many tasks are finished by the review time? 12 tasks only. Actually, how many we have to finish? 15 tasks, but 12 tasks only finished. Okay, so that is, what is this? BCWS. So summing, add all these effort. Add all these. Task 1 plus task 2, task plus task 3, and so on. Sum of all the. So this is individual, but we are trying to find for the completed. Okay, BCWS is 126.5. okay, next, what we have to calculate? BCWP. What do you mean BCWP? Actually implemented. Actually implemented. How many are implemented? 12 are implemented. Okay, budget cost of work performed by the given review date. How many tasks are completed? 12 tasks are completed. Okay, so that is BCWP. Budgeted cost of work performed. This is scheduled. This is work performed. Okay, to finish 12 tasks, 126.5 hours are required. assume the case. But comes to actual scenario, 127.5 hours are required, or 126.5 persons are required, person days are required, 127.5 person days are taken. Okay, so like this. Now BAC, how will you calculate BAC? The sum of all the scheduled, okay, sum of all the scheduled tasks planned. Okay, so what is its value? 156.5, sum of. So it indicates how many tasks are scheduled by the given time, BCWS. Okay, how many are finished by the given review date. Okay, and the whole project. Okay, BAC. So using these parameters, we have to calculate the remaining parameters. Okay, SPI. How will you calculate SPI? Scheduled Performance Index, BCWP divided by BCWS. Okay, so you will get. Okay, scheduled performance index is 1.008. And scheduled variance, how will you calculate scheduled variance? BCWP minus BCWS. Okay, so what is that? 1% day, the variance. Okay, so it is a minimal value, so we can continue the project. Okay, if it is more, assume the case if it is 10 or 20 or 30, so we have to pay more attention where is the problem is existing. That is identifying the critical activities, focusing more on the critical activities. Okay, next, percent complete. So how will you calculate percent complete? BCWP divided by BAC. Okay, so 81% is completed. Okay, so like this way we have to calculate. So next we have to calculate the other parameters, ACWP. So what do you mean ACWP? Actual cost work performed. So it's not easy to calculate. We have to know the budget. Okay, then only it is easy to find. Okay, here we are, the budget is not given. Okay, so we'll stop here. We will continue in the next session, other problem. Okay, end value analysis.